If I ask you, what are your first thoughts when I say God, what would you say to me? 20 years ago, I would have said that if he exists, he was a cold and distant God, because I didn't grow up as a Christian. I didn't grow up with any mention really of Jesus or any religious upbringing. But every time I looked at the stars at night, I could see something bigger. And I knew that there must be a God. There must be something out there that created this amazing world with such order and complexity. But I didn't know him. I didn't know him at all. And I always thought that he was cold and distant. And as I was growing up, especially in my teenage years, going into university, I had this emptiness inside me that I was just trying to fill with drinking and parties and just trying to fit in. But I didn't get any joy from these things. And it wasn't until about midway in university where I just unconsciously surrounded myself with Christian friends, because they were always smiling. They were always happy. They knew how to have a good time without the drinking, the swearing, the parties that went with it. And so I was naturally drawn to these people. And one person in particular, every time we would meet together as a group of friends, she would tell us how God was answering her prayers. You know, about simple things, small things. One time she lost her purse. She looked in her room. She couldn't find it anywhere. She looked on top of her bed. She looked under her bed. She looked in her bag twice. She couldn't find it anywhere. Then the thought came into her head, well, why don't I pray about it? And so she said a simple prayer, dear God, help me to find my purse. Amen. And as soon as she said amen, the thought came into her head, why don't you check your bag one more time? She says, well, I've already checked it twice. It's definitely not there, but okay, I'll check it one more time. And when she checked her bag, there was her purse right on top. Now, when she said that to me, I could hardly believe it, because I had never heard of a God like that who would answer such a small, insignificant prayer in such a quick, powerful way. And I was interested. Outside, I was cold. I didn't show any emotion, but inside, I was going, wow. I've never heard of anything like this. Another time, she was struggling with money. She was barely able to afford her rent, her living expenses. She needed just a certain amount just to pay the bills. A friend of hers, a preacher, said to her, anytime you're in trouble, just pray. And so she did. And she prayed for a specific amount every fortnight to be able to help her to pay her bills. That week, after she had prayed, she got a letter from OzStudy saying that her payments had increased by just the amount she had been praying for. Now, when I had heard that, again, I was amazed, because I had been a part of Centrelink for years and they never increased my payments. But yet when this girl needed it, she just prayed and God answered in such a powerful, miraculous way. And there was many other experiences as well, but this gave me a hunger. I want to know this personal God. I want to know this God that answers prayer. And so I had this hunger to find this God more and more. And I don't know how I knew, but I said, well, there's so many different religions. I want to know the truth. And I think the only way to know the truth is to read the Bible. And so I made a decision. I'm going to start to read the Bible. But I kept on putting it off and putting it off and putting it off. Until one day, I was watching cartoons in the morning. Don't judge. I was watching cartoons in the morning, and then the children's programs came on and I switched it off, and I was supposed to be studying for an exam, but my girlfriend's Bible was on the floor. And I remember it just like it was yesterday, even though it was 20 years ago. Her Bible was just on the floor, and the thought very strongly, not audibly, but very strongly came into my head, Paul, you've put it off long enough. Pick up the Bible and start to read it. And so I did. I picked it up, went to the first page of the Bible, started to read the book of Genesis for the very first time in my life. And I read this whole book. It's quite a large book. I read it in one sitting. And there I saw this personal God that my friends had been telling me about, who was working in Abraham's life, in Isaac's life, in Jacob's life. And he started to speak to me, grow in my life. Who is this God? And as I was reading through the Bible, that started my journey to read the Bible every day and to find this God that I was looking for. Now, it took me a year to read that Bible, and I've got many experiences through that of how God spoke to me through His Word. But after that year, and especially as I read the New Testament and found out about Jesus Christ, He changed my life, friends. And He turned my life upside down, turning me from darkness and emptiness and hopelessness to giving me purpose, to giving me peace, and giving me a plan in my life. And that's exactly what He wants to do for you as well. In fact, I want to read to you a verse in Jeremiah 29, verses 11 to 13. Jeremiah 29, verses 11 to 13. Because I remember reading this, and it spoke to me way back then when I was first reading the Bible. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." Friends, if you don't know this personal, wonderful God, I want to invite you to get to know Him, to seek Him with all your heart, because He promises that He will be found by you. More than that, He wants to be involved in your life, to give you that peace, to give you that purpose, and to show you a better way to live. Hi, my name's Paul Kleinmeulman, and I hope you enjoyed the video today. If you did, please leave a like and an encouraging comment down below, because it really helps. We want to upload videos Mondays and Wednesdays and Fridays, and we don't want you to miss one, so please consider subscribing as well. Thank you, and God bless.